Greetings, Cauldron of Weird fans. Welcome back. It's time for Japanuary episode 3. So, we have a band that I've actually seen. This band is called Hide. They opened up for Starset at the end.
Oh, yeah.
The beginning of November, I think. Somewhere around there. I think it was the beginning of November, but it was the second. I remember this. Anyway, this band is called Hyde.
H-Y-D-E, right?
Yes.
Like Jekyll and Hyde.
Yes.
Okay.
They're from Japan. They're incredible live. They're absolutely incredible live. Their showmanship is out of this world. So I figured, why not do a reaction for it on the channel?
And the best month of all, Japanuary.
Japanuary, exactly. Perfect. You're getting it. So
it's all coming together.
Oh, yeah. It's all coming together now.
Bader.
We're going to get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Song's called Afterlight, by the way.
That might be a nice little helpful tidbit. Contacts. Okay.
He wore them during the show.
Oh, did he? Nice. Little fishnet around.
He's got some like Manson vibes going on.
Yeah, I didn't want to. I hate it when we compare people to Marilyn Manson, but it kind of has
just in like look and aesthetic.
Yeah. The only thing we need now is more guy liner.
Oh, that's cool.
They got a good sound to them. Mm-hmm. I like them.
Although they had no more merch by the time they got to our show, because it was the final show of the tour.
Oh.
I wonder fucking why.
There we go, a little fluorescent paint with a black light paint. That was pretty cool. Like, right in his arm motion, I think. That's what I want to be. Bored on my throne.
He's got a lot of the same like facial motions too.
Yeah.
No, not industrial.
This is for new metal right now.
More just industrial metal.
Yeah.
Earth Manson. Hey, LA Kings shirt, take that off. I'll get you a Blue Jack shirt next time you're in town.
It's on me. It's on me. Hell yeah.
This lemonade's disgusting.
I said I wanted Mountain Dew. They have a really cool sound, dude. Really cool sound.
Yeah, I'm telling you, they were freaking awesome. They were absolutely freaking awesome.
So, I mean, it hits all the stuff that we were talking about. It hits with the, again, the I guess the stylized very similar to like a Marilyn Manson. You know,
at least,
kind of like
again, just like visually with him,
yeah,
with the singer.
Doesn't sound anything like Marilyn Manson. So, but he kind of went for that kind of more... I guess creep vibe, kind of unsettling,
yes,
post-human kind of look to it. So, you know, I kind of I dig it. It's a very good aesthetic. Even something as simple as, like, again, like fishnet kind of over here, it really kind of encompasses a good look. I do like, I'm gonna steal something from another band, but I kind of like it when someone does like what a Ghost does, where you have like a lead singer who kind of has an unusual look, and then everyone else kind of has like certain attributes that are very similar. Like all of them had like other masks on.
Yeah,
like, you know, so it kind of goes.
They all had them on during the entire performance.
I really dig stuff like that because there's a certain.
I forget what
visual element that comes with that.
I forget what he's from. He's from something.
Okay.
And you keep talking.
I'll keep talking. So I think it's really good when it adds a certain look to a band. So it's something very recognizable. But this particular music video, I thought it had really good visuals to it. Really good camera work. I like kind of the.
Oh, he is Hyde. The singer is Hyde.
Singer is Hyde. Okay.
Hideto Takara. I can't say that. Takarai?
Oh, don't let me fucking know. Yeah, I won't even make an attempt at that.
Known by his stage name, Hyde is a Japanese musician. In 1991, Hyde left his band Jerusalem's Rod and joined this band. I can't say the name of this band.
By the way, fucking awesome name, Jerusalem's
he
Rod.
He's the vocalist for Vamps. I've heard of Vamps.
Oh, yeah. Tight.
Yeah, I definitely know the band Vamps. So this is a solo project for him then.
Interesting.
Technically.
Which it makes sense, I guess, if he's the main kind of attraction and then everyone else is kind of supporting him.
Okay, but, that makes sense. That makes sense, though.
So music video, I think I'm going to give the music video, I think like an 8.5. Yeah, it's like again, I'm a sucker for story and stuff like that. This is kind of more of just like, you know, keep it flashy, keep it entertaining, and, you know, kind of go throughout the song.
I will say the part where he put the liquid in his mouth and then just spit it all out.
I think I'm going to throw up.
It was mildly comical. I'm not going to lie.
By the way, dude.
Did take a little
Total sucker for, like, you know, bored look on a throne, you know? Like, I love that kind of
look. I can't be bothered.
Yeah, it's just like, I can't deal with your mortal problems, you know, kind of shit like that. I love stuff like that. I think like 8.5 is what I'm going to rate that. I think the song, I'm going to give it a solid 9. I'm going to give it a solid 9. I think he has incredibly good vocals, really good instrumentals too, by the way. Like, I think maybe get a little bit overshadowed because of him,
mm-hmm.
which I guess it's him, so he should be the main focus. But I thought they did a pretty good job of kind of supporting him. Again, Good vocalist right there. A much cleaner sound than I was maybe expecting, if that makes any type of sense. Like, it didn't have a... I don't know. I guess when I was looking at him, I guess maybe kind of in the air of, like, closer to, like, a harder heavy metal sound.
Sure.
Just from pure visual looks. And we know with, again, Ghost, that looks are very deceiving. So I think it's kind of neat to see these guys kind of on a stage performing. And they just have a different sound than you were anticipating. So subverting expectations. That's what we call it in the biz.
Is that?
Subverting expectation.
Like the subverting the expectation that we're going to grow up anytime?
That'll never happen. So buckle in, buckaroos.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree. I really love their stage presence. I really love like the overall aesthetic of the group of...
It's very noticeable.
Yeah,
it's hard noticeable. To differentiate yourself now because everyone does everything. So anything you can do to kind of give yourself a new look, and it's a very fresh look. It really is.
Yeah, and like all the blacklight stuff, and you know that's definitely a callback to like a lot of those. Mm-hmm. I guess what's the word I'm looking for? It's like kind of that like 2000s goth time where everything was like.
Yeah.
Done under blacklight and you could see everything.
It's like when,
and it was very
it's like when every teenager realized what a blacklight was and so they just kind of like just fucking go crazy with it. Yeah.
Yeah, basically. I dig it. I dig it though.
I do. I think it's a good look. It's not cyberpunky, which we're now in a cyberpunk world, so
we need to be in a more of a cyberpunk world. Or a cyber goth world. I want to be in a cyber goth world.
Fuck yeah, dude. It's coming back. Dude, Matrix 4 is coming out next year.
If I don't
it's fucking coming back.
If I don't get some goddamn tube dreads in that, I'm going to be very cross. But no, back to the song. All back right, to sorry. The song. It's I love this song. This song's really,
it's catchy,
really good. I give it a 10.
Yeah?
I give it a 10. I really like it.
And again, this is purely me just watching it on this side of a screen for 3 minutes and 18 seconds, and you've seen a whole set.
Yeah, it was like a 45-minute set from them.
That's
they should have been. I'm going to say it now, and take this for what you will. They should have been above Palisades on that set list.
Really?
On that set. Absolutely.
Wow.
They were clearly better. Palisades is...
Wow.
I'm not trying to be mean, but I do not enjoy... I've seen Palisades like 6 times now, and not one time have I enjoyed them.
Again, right back to subverting expectation.
And I've tried. I've given them many chances. I just don't enjoy them. Hyde should have been higher up on there. They put a better show. I would assume Hyde has a larger audience considering that he's from Japan and that was an American audience. Or maybe that's why Palisades was higher up. But
it could be.
No, Hyde was great. Hyde was really, really good. I would strongly recommend anyone who gets the chance to go do that. If he's coming to a town near you, I would seriously suggest that. With our code for SeatGeek, we'll get to that. But no, I really enjoy this song. I think it's 10. I really think it's 10.
Do they all kind of have a very similar sound in terms of other songs in their set?
No, they vary. That is the overall, like...
If you had to average their tonal...
If you average it, I would say Afterlight's a pretty solid representation.
Okay.
I will say he screams in a number of the songs he did on stage. And it's a real raspy kind of shouting scream. And it was... fucking great.
Was it? Wow.
Yeah, it was great. It was really like raspy and like,
because that would fit closer to the like the actual
tone of the band.
Yeah,
and it fits what they're trying to do really well. And it's like the first time we did it, I was just like, oh.
Interesting.
But yeah, super cool, super fun. Would highly recommend.
I'll have to check more out of them. Yeah, it's We watched, I guess we only watched like a couple seconds of like some live stuff there too before we did the recording of this. And even from just not a music video, just from a live recording, it's like it looks like really good stage presence. Looks like they kind of, again, always kind of fit that look. And it's very attractive. It's very appealing. It almost kind of fits no matter what kind of venue you're at too. You know, sometimes there's like some venues that's like, you know, you're either, you know, really close and personal venue or a really large one. Sometimes the overall appearance can be a little goofy,
mm-hmm.
but it actually looked really good even in a smaller kind of setting.
Well, keep in mind that they performed at Express Live.
Shit, too.
So, well, wow. So the indoor stage, because that's where, you know, you put shows like that in November.
Yeah.
Snow. Which is, you know, 2,200 people.
Yeah.
That's a good crowd for a rock concert.
God, I just want 2,200 people to watch our video sometimes. Well, that's not true. All of them. Maybe 22 million.
That would be cool. We're not that.
We got 22,000 on lock. 22,000, easy.
How many likes do we want to get in this video? What's a like goal for the crowd?
Honestly, I think 100 is just a nice, nice even number.
So do that. Give us 100 likes, and we'll do a fourth Japanuary episode.
And I really want to do one.
So this will be the final one. Unless you guys help us out.
Got to tease it a little. Dangle the carrot just a little.
So, you make the choice, and we'll see you in a couple weeks, guys.
Bye.
Bye.